In 1967, ITV sent a reporter to go interview Paul McCartney. The reporter and cameraman had a difficult time finding Paul McCartney at first in his house on Cavendish Road, but eventually they found it and were shown warmly through the front door and out to the garden. The cameraman set up the big old black and white film, and it was off to the races. And the interview proceeds as normal for a few minutes until the reporter asked Paul McCartney a question that to this day, so many celebrities still get asked.
Have you taken LSD?
About four times.
But as a public figure, surely you've got a responsibility to lots.
And Paul McCartney's answer is so unusual, so uncommon, that it teaches us more about the paradoxes of mainstream media than we could ever learn in a classroom. The interaction is like a warm melting pot of ideas. It's like America in 1895, full of clashing philosophical ideas, chief among them being utilitarianism and Immanuel Kant.
Don't you believe that this was a matter which you should have kept private?
But the thing is, you know, that I was asked a question by a newspaper, and the decision was whether to tell a lie or to tell him the truth, you know. I decided to tell him the truth. But I really didn't want to say anything, you know, because if I'd had my decision, you know, if I had it my way, I wouldn't have told anyone, you know, because I'm not trying to spread the word about this. Yes, but to say it, you know, is only to tell the truth. I'm telling the truth, you know. I don't know what everyone's so angry about.
Well, do you think you have now encouraged your fans to take drugs?
I don't think it'll make any difference.
Essentially, the reporter is asserting a utilitarian argument to Paul McCartney. And Paul McCartney is responding, no. My obligation is not one of utility. It's not to serve the group for the greater good. It's one of a moral imperative, a Kantian moral imperative to tell the truth. You come seeking an interview with me, reporter, and I'm going to tell you the truth. You may not like the answer. It may not be for the betterment of society, but I am here to tell you the truth. And Paul McCartney further asserts, maybe not in as academic terms as I'm describing them, but philosophically, that not only do I, Paul McCartney, have a moral imperative to tell you the truth, if that's what you want as a journalist, but that you, the media, have the utilitarian obligation to society. You're the ones that have the ability to broadcast this interview to millions of homes across this country, into the impressionable young minds of tomorrow. That if you really cared about my answer, my response, and thought it would harm the greater good of society, you could withhold the information.
You know, I don't think my fans are going to take drugs just because I did, you know. But the thing is, that's not the point anyway. You know, I was asked whether I had or not. And then from then on, the whole bit about how far it's going to go and how many people it's going to encourage is up to the newspapers and up to you, you know, on television. I mean, you're spreading this now at this moment. This is going into all the homes, you know, in Britain.
And this argument, is it the moral imperative or the utilitarian argument that gets at the heart of contemporary journalism? ITV ran that interview later that night. So ultimately, to quote Gandhi, actions express priorities. And that action expresses that in reality, contemporary mass media takes the same argument that Paul McCartney took. They have a moral imperative to tell the truth, an obligation to their audience to report faithfully what they've been told. To omit information, particularly key information, would be a lie of omission. And so, journalism, like Paul McCartney, take the same argument, often reporting information that's to the detriment of society in the name of some greater moral imperative, not a utilitarian argument. But is that the right thing for media to do? Paul McCartney follows up with the reporter saying, I'm just a man, and I'm more than happy to keep this thing that I did private. I'm only sharing it because you're asking me to.
The whole bit about how far it's going to go and how many people it's going to encourage is up to the newspapers and up to you, you know, on television. I mean, you're spreading this now at this moment. This is going into all the homes, you know, in Britain. You know, I'm quite prepared to keep it as a very personal thing, if you will too. If you'll shut up about it, I will.
And so, ultimately, It's a question that media hasn't answered. How much culpability, responsibility does mass media have in electing presidents? How much responsibility does mass media have in the continuation of mass shootings? How much responsibility did ITV have in planting the seed of taking LSD in the minds of people watching television that night? It's a tough question. What do you guys think? Is Paul McCartney right? Or is the reporter right? Is the obligation for the greater good or for the moral imperative to always tell the truth? The psychologist Jordan Peterson, who has a New York Times bestselling book, 12 Rules for Life, number 8 is do not lie. And here we can see the full nuanced outcomes of that philosophy. Because to not lie is to sometimes go against what may be for the greater good of society. Especially when you're a big figure or a big media institution. It's an interesting philosophical paradox. Like I said, one that journalism really hasn't answered for itself. But that's why I find this interview so insightful at the same time. Let me know what you guys think down below. I'm curious to see your guys' thoughts. Hopefully you found this interview thought-provoking and insightful too. If you did, like, subscribe. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.